After being whooped, after being spat on, after being called names, after being nailed to a cross, after being naked on the cross, people were waiting, people were anticipating, people wanted a response from Jesus. And when he finally spoke, they heard the word forsaken. They heard the word alone. They heard the word unwanted. They heard the phrase Elohi, Elohi, lema sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? This phrase can be found in Matthew chapter 27, verse 46, or Mark chapter 15, verses 33 through 39, and this is what it reads. When it was noon, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. At 3 o'clock, when this cry was a loud voice, Elohi, Elohi, lema sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? When some of the bystanders heard it, they said, listen, he is calling for Elijah. And someone ran for the sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink, saying, wait, let us see whether Elijah will come and take him in. Then Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last breath. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. Now, when the centurion who was stood facing him saw that in this way he breathed his last breath, he said, truly, this man is God's son. Now, when we read this passage, the only word that sticks out, the only word that leaps out and goes straight to our minds and straight into our hearts is that one word, forsaken. Now, for us being true Christians, we don't want to focus on that word. We want to focus on love. We want to focus on salvation. We don't want to focus on that word, forsaken. How can my Jesus say God has forsaken him? We say, is God really Jesus? And we can't do that. Because if you say that, then what about us? What about me? How about my problem? Is God going to forsake me? Is God going to leave me alone? Am I going to be unwanted? Am I going to be alone? Especially now during this economy. I know some of you are worried about your job. I know some of you are worried about paying bills. I know some of you are worried about your family members, those who are not walking in Christ. And I know some of you are stressed, and some of you have all these things going in your mind, and you're just pacing back and forth. You're up late at night, and you just think, and you think, and it's on the tip of your tongue, and you're on the verge of saying, God, why have you forsaken me? But you don't. You keep holding it in, and you're holding it in, and you don't want to say it, but it's in your mind. You say, God, have you really, truly forsaken me? I know as a good Christian, you don't want to think that. Especially with this phrase that we have to read. Elohi, Elohi, lema sabachthani, the word Jesus Christ once mentioned. Did God really need Jesus? Now let me assure you, God did not need Jesus. Now let's get into that in a moment. So what did Jesus mean by saying, Elohi, Elohi, lema sabachthani, my God, why have you forsaken me? Here, what Jesus is doing, he's actually quoting scripture. His very last words, it's not agony, it's not his own words, it's not him giving up, it's him going back and reading Psalm 22. And he just doesn't say it. And here in the Bible, he just doesn't say it in English. It actually makes specific reference to go back to Aramaic. And they do that on purpose. They do that because they don't want you to think that that's Jesus' really word, to learn his actual word. He purposely put it in Aramaic. Elohi, Elohi, lema sabachthani. My God, why are you forsaken me? Now, you cannot read this scripture without going back to Psalm 22, because that's where it actually comes from. This psalm is actually divided into two parts, if you really look at Psalm 22. The first part is a point of sorrow, and yes, it's a point of pain. And that's actually what Jesus read. He read the first part. But the second part, the part that Jesus, he could not say it because he was literally bored, quiet. People put a sponge in is now, because today's the second part. This is the second part. It is a point of thanksgiving and redemption. And it's saying, yes, you may be going through pain now, but wait, because redemption comes. Wait, because that pain will be gone.
Right.
That's what he was going to say. And Jesus quotes this psalm, and he's not able to finish. He stopped. And as I mentioned earlier, God allows Jesus to be forsaken. He does, but not by God himself. He's forsaken by us. As Christians, when we see Jesus hanging on the cross, we must remember that Jesus is both God and he's also man. We must view Jesus as God who is unchangeable, the God who cannot be moved, the God that we know as God is love. Now, the thing that's tricky about being the God of love, as you all know, as parents, or if you have a girlfriend or a boyfriend, anyone, if you love someone, there's a chance that you might get hurt. There's a chance that you might be forsaken, that you might be left alone, because you love someone. And God is the God of love, and he loves us. He truly does. And whenever he sees us in pain, whenever he sees us sinning, whenever he sees us confused and worried and stressed and worried about our loved ones who don't know Jesus Christ, he is in pain as well. So when he says, Elohi, Elohi, why have you forsaken me? He should be saying, God, why have you given me such great love for these people? Because whenever they're in pain, I am in pain. Whenever they're stressed about a bill that they can't pay, I'm stressed for them. Whenever I see them doubting on the verge of saying, God, why have you forsaken me? He is there. He is there saying, wait, because the second part is coming. Right now, you may be in the first part of the psalm, where you're just stressed, you're worried, but the second part is coming.
Amen.
The redemption is coming.
Praise Jesus. Hallelujah.
Just don't focus on the first part. Do not give up. Do not let people put things in your mouth and shut you up. That is the time to speak out, and say, redemption is coming.
Amen.
I will be free because Jesus died for me.
Amen.
Now let me finish the psalm that Jesus wanted to end. It's Psalm 22, verses 29 through 31. And it reads, to him indeed shall all who sleep in the earth bow down. Before him shall bow all who go down to the dust, and I shall live for him. Posterity will serve him. Future generations will be told about the Lord and proclaim his deliverance to people yet unborn, saying that he has done it.
Hallelujah.
So let me encourage you, when you read this scripture that says, Elohi, Elohi, lema sabachthani, Lord, my God, why have you forsaken me? Be encouraged.
Amen.
Be encouraged. Look at the very last verse. He has done it.
Amen.
He has died for me. He has died for you. He loves you. And he will never leave you nor forsake you. He wants to give you the blessing. He wants to give you the riches. He wants to liberate you.
Hallelujah.
But you must believe it.
Right.
Don't forsake him. I know you're on the verge of giving up. I know you're on the verge of being stressed. I know you're on the verge of just losing it and saying, God, why? Why? And you're just not there. You're not saying it yet. The blessings will come.
Amen.
The blessings will come.
Jesus.
He has done it. Amen.
Amen.